I somewhat feel that I put myself in this extremely bad situation to bring about the utmost effort to get what really works. And it's working. It's working. You know, if I had money, I wouldn't be doing this. Not like this. No way. Nobody would. They'd be traveling, going places, sightseeing, meeting people, and doing enjoyable things, having fun, shopping. Well, all the stuff that people do. I can't do any of that. All I can do is just sit here in extreme concern about future troubles. So it puts puts extreme pressure on me. And it's working because I have to come up with these radical solutions that otherwise you wouldn't think about. So, welcome to the late night version here. Sometimes we do our best work at this time, when everyone else is sleeping. Now, I've been sitting here for quite some time, silently, still, seeing if I can allow an answer to come through that is unexpected and one has finally come through. It is an affirmation. Like all affirmations, do not try and attach anything to it. It's universal. Universal. And say, all is zero times zero. 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 And I will explain this. Reading in A Journey Beyond Words, which is the voice of Jesus speaking to Dr. Brent Haskell, Jesus says that you cannot experience knowledge in this world, true knowledge, you cannot. So don't worry about it. So, well, if that's true, then the next best thing we can do experience is zero times zero, is zero times zero. So we do not have to try to reach the ultimate here. That's a mistake. He says you cannot get to knowledge in this world. I believe what he says. So who's sponsoring this drive for the ultimate? The ego. The ego. The ego knows that we can't get there. So of course it's sponsoring it. And then making us feel guilty that we're not trying to reach the highest. You see that trick? So I said reject it. Zero times zero is what we're aiming for. All is zero times zero. This is an absolute statement. And you're going to even look at the absolute as zero times zero. You're not going to try to be the absolute, knowledge of the absolute while we're here. You're not going to even try to do that. Jesus says you can get little glimpses of it. Okay, but functionally, no. So we're just going to say the absolute is zero times zero. That's how we're going to see it. All is zero times zero. All is zero times zero. Now we can groove this into our mind by saying it over and over. Do not attach it to anything. The point is we want to get this brute acceptance of that all is zero times zero. So we're not thinking it, you don't have to think, well, is this zero times zero, or what about this, or what about that? No, there's no discussion of this and that. All is zero times zero. There's only zero times zero. All is zero times zero. All is zero times zero. Form, the pure, the space that form occupies, that space is seamless with the space that form does not occupy. Okay? This is what we mean zero times zero. All is zero times zero. And the space that form does not occupy is also exactly the same spaciousness that form does occupy. All is zero times zero. Without any exception, without having to think about it, judge it in the slightest bit, just affirm this. All is zero times zero. 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 Again, this is an affirmation. You're not trying to figure out how it applies to anything. It automatically applies to everything. So we're simply holding this affirmation in our presence. All is zero times zero. 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 Don't try to imagine anything. Don't say, do you mean this? Or do you mean that? Or what about this? No. Block all that out. All is zero times zero. All. All is zero times zero. All is zero times zero. Burn that groove into your mind. Today we've been burning grooves into our mind, right? Started out, well, yesterday was no layers, no levels, only zero. No layers, no levels, only zero. No layers, no levels, only zero. Or also today was, what am I really? What am I really? What am I really? And now it's, all is zero times zero. All is zero times zero. All is zero times zero. Burn this into your mind, as it were. All is zero times zero. So you don't have to even think about it. We're not thinking about it. We're stating it as a fact. All is zero times zero. We're saying, this is what I'm seeing. This is my perception. Zero times zero. This is my experience. All is zero times zero. Don't worry how it gets applied. Don't allow yourself to be dragged into that. Just say, all is zero times zero. This is how I'm going to perceive everything. All is zero times zero. All is zero times zero. Zero times zero. All is zero times zero. Give it a try. All is zero times zero. Don't apply it. It's completely abstract. It's completely generalized. It covers everything. All is zero times zero. No exceptions. No exceptions. All is zero times zero. The importance of making affirmations is it gets to no exceptions so quickly, as opposed to thinking and trying to figure everything out, trying to fit everything together. That's impossible. affirmations, they're not giving any room for exceptions whatsoever. All is zero times zero. All is zero times zero. There's no room for exceptions there whatsoever. All is zero times zero. To do thinking, all is zero times zero. Just stick with the presence of that affirmation. Jesus tells us to try to go beyond thinking and start feeling. Feeling is always saying to feel. Occasionally I can do that, but usually like this, what's being said is so taboo, there's tremendous fear in bringing it to the light and sharing it with the world. All is zero times zero. So I feel like nervous. It's like strain. Wow. All is zero times zero. Because I know it's extremely taboo to think in this way. But we don't think about that, do we? We just affirm it. We just try the best we can. All is zero times zero. And if we cannot affirm it seems too difficult, then don't struggle with it. But also don't think about, well, what stopped me from it? How come I can't do that? No. Just give yourself a little breather, a little, you know, continuity fear is kicking up. Continuity fear is kicking up. Absolute statements are the way to go. Absolute statements are the way to go. That brings us to purity, which is, there's no time, the timeless. Absolute statements are the way to go. Zero times zero. You may say, well, that's not an absolute statement. Zero times zero. It's as close as we can get here to the absolute. So we're being realistic and pragmatic. Not letting the ego goad us into chasing after what we can't attain. See, that's stupid. We can attain here. All is zero times zero. Absolutely, all is zero times zero. The ego will laugh and say, "Ah, oh, I can go higher than that." And I just say, "Well, all is zero times zero. All is zero times zero." The very fact the ego says I can go higher than that, you see, shows its duality. Or saying all is zero times zero is recognizing our continuity problem with duality, and at the same time emphasizing our willingness to drop the whole duality just as it is without trying to change anything. All is zero times zero already. We don't have to change the world nor to set it down, not the slightest bit. It's all zero times zero, all is zero times zero already. Is there any search that can ever find that which is not occupying pure spaciousness? Or the absence of that is not occupying pure spaciousness? Tell me what kind of search can be made to find that. Let's look at that. Let's look at that. what search can be found? What search can be made, Ken? What search can be made that will successfully find that which is not occupying pure spaciousness? And if there isn't that which is not occupying pure spaciousness, then what kind of search can be made that can get close to that if there is no that? If there is no that, there's also no close to it, is there? There's also no farther away from it, is there? You see, all is zero times zero. All is zero times zero. There's no closer and there's no farther away from that which doesn't occupy pure spaciousness, because there is no that which doesn't occupy pure spaciousness. So there is no closer or farther away of any search at all, the object of any search at all. As where perception of objects is a search, actually. It's actually a search. Sensory perception is a search. And it gives the impression of that which is closer to us. Has a different quality of presence than that which is farther away. So from that we can infer that there are differences in occupying pure spaciousness. So sensory perception is a search. We're looking to find that which does not occupy pure spaciousness, and we're presuming it somewhere. So we presume distant, closer, farther away. But I say all is zero times zero. There's no closer and there's no farther away. If there isn't any center, where's closer and where's farther away? If all is occupying pure spaciousness equally, what does it mean to be closer or farther away in that regard? Am I closer to that which doesn't? Am I farther away from that which doesn't occupy pure spaciousness? No, can't say that, because there isn't any such that. So, is there any way to feel closer? Is there any way to feel farther away? No. In regard to pure spaciousness, you cannot feel closer and you cannot feel farther away. Zero times zero. All is zero times zero. The closer is zero, the farther away is zero. You see? Zero times zero. So everything, all is zero times zero. All is zero times zero. We're working on the root of the situation here. Jesus says that's where the Holy Spirit works with us. We get frustrated trying to get the Holy Spirit to work with us in different, somewhere else. It doesn't seem to do that. You have to listen to what it says. All is zero times zero. This definitely puts a strain on the system. as strong, but I'm not trying to do anything strenuous or active or anything, so it's okay. As long as I'm breathing, that's fine. There's a lot of strain on the system. Zero times zero. Again, just be with the presence of the statement. Don't interpret it. Don't intellectualize it. Don't think about it. Don't try to figure it out. Don't try to apply it. Don't try to measure the results. Don't try to anticipate the results. None of that. Just stay with the presence of it. Like spirit just stating a fact. All is zero times zero. 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 Zero times zero. All is zero times zero. All is zero times zero. Now, as much as possible, stay with the presence of that and the potencies and the presence of it. Not applying it to the future, not applying it to the past, not applying it to anything in particular, to all. The all is right here, right now. This, all is zero times zero. All is zero times zero. All is zero times zero. So right now is where everything is, right? Both manifest and unmanifest. Everything in the entire universe that is manifest right now, whatever appearance it may have. And everything that is unmanifest is also unmanifest right now. And that's always the case, isn't it? Zero times zero. Okay, so you can also say all is manifest and unmanifest right now. The manifest, unmanifest all is all right now. The unmanifest, manifest all is all here right now. It's all present. there's so much fear surrounding these statements because continuity fear of the world is so extreme. It's like breaking the ice. Once the ice is broken, then it's easy to go right through. It's just water. You say, hey, what's the difficulty here? But breaking the ice is like incredibly difficult. That's what I am, an icebreaker. Is, you know, it's something to do. Oh yeah, once the taboo is lifted and the ice is broken, sail right through and say, ah, what's the big deal? Why is it difficult? Come on. That couldn't have been that difficult. No, it definitely is. All is zero times zero. All is zero times zero. You see, the nerves that come from the brain, which are activated by the mind, have been conditioned and told, do not support the functioning of the body, and especially the voice, the breath, which is based on the breath, right, and the vocal cords and the lungs. Do not allow the body to speak these things. That's why it's such a difficult effort to say these things. All is zero times zero. Right now. All is zero times zero right now. All is zero times zero right now. All is zero times zero right now. And so the nerves, my nervous system, as it's going towards the lungs and the solar plexus, just the body in general, is like, it's like a tremendous struggle, because the commands, demands that have been ingrained is, don't, you can't say this, no one can say it, it's unspeakable, don't dare say it. So it's an effort of will, very much an effort of will. All is zero times zero. All is zero times zero. If in certain situations, if I meet up with those who are very much opposed to this, try to speak, my voice just disappears. Can't even have my voice, just gone, can't talk. And everybody in the world, just to greater or less extent, is opposed to truth being spoken here, which is why I stay by myself to do this. Makes it a lot easier, actually. It's difficult enough for me to say it, let alone to say it to someone else. You know, saying it to the camera. The camera's just inanimate, so it doesn't matter. And then posting it is another effort of will. And getting it up there online is another effort of will. You know, it's just very difficult, very difficult. This. All is zero times zero. All is zero times zero. All is zero times zero. Now, maybe for you, hearing it's very difficult. Because we're also to not to hear anything like this, not to pay any attention to anything like this. Do not pay attention. That's the taboo. So you're paying attention to this. Is breaking that taboo, is ice breaking as well. So there's two ice breakings going on here. My saying it and you hearing it. And also then you applying it, saying it yourself, more ice breaking. So it's a chain reaction of ice breaking. I'm not the only ice breaker. Everyone who's listening and doing this of affirmations are doing tremendous ice breaking as well. So it's a kind of a collective ice breaking. Something moving around in the dark. I don't know what. Man. Okay, well, it's been a tough day, but a great day. A lot of ice breaking today. Tremendous, tremendous. All right, that concludes this late night edition. And for you, maybe the morning edition. Along with I did the midday or the afternoon edition, which is should be published by midnight or so here West Coast time, so it'll be available there for everybody in the morning, and then this will I'll upload it, and then next morning I'll edit it together and publish it, and that takes a couple hours, so should be ready also, you know, it should be ready in the morning time. And we need this stuff. We need to break the ice. We need to find your voice. Find your voice. All is zero times zero. 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 All right. Just keep doing it. Keep doing it. Groove it. Groove it. Find your voice. Keep grooving it. Keep grooving it. Keep grooving it as fast as possible. Just, you know, it's like do it three times. Have three sessions a day. I'm finding three all-out sessions a day. Very important. Break all that ice up. So that your ship is gone into warm waters when the big freeze hits this world. Your ship will be in warm waters and still be free where everyone else, the water will freeze up so badly. Their ships are just locked in place, you know, like that. Because of the big freeze, the big ideological freeze is coming very soon. Sudden mental climate shift on this planet, like a mental polar shift. You heard about the pole shift. Well, it could be a mental pole shift too, couldn't it? First, it may be a mental pole shift. Maybe a mental stalling out of the Atlantic current, right? Which means that the means a lot of things. There's ways that this planet can stall out. There's ways that our minds can stall out. The mental aspect can stall out. And I mean, you talk about a mental change here. So there's a way to get to warm climate, warm waters, so to speak. So the freeze hits and you say, I'm fine. I'm fine. Can't freeze the whole place. not going to freeze the whole place mentally, so to speak. I'm speaking mentally. I don't know exactly how much this is going to spill onto this level here, of the physical level. So by all means, break the ice, get out of that harbor, make your way towards the warm weather, the warm harbors where the water is too warm to freeze. Yeah. All is zero times zero. 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 See, you keep doing concentrated bursts like that. Concentrated bursts, concentrated bursts. Keep doing it, keep doing it. If you can do it all day, you'll make unbelievable progress. Okay, but don't have a lot of time left, so keep after it very actively right now. Okay, just give it like 3 solid efforts in a day. Okay, that's it for now.